Hello everyone, today I am going to discuss formulas in MS Excel. Inside this formula, values, operators, parenthesis and function, formula bar and what is pointing we will see. A formula in MS Excel start with an equal sign and can be maximum of 1024 character in length. See the example here. Four plus eight, no result. With is equal to, start with is equal to four plus eight. It gives the result 12. So formulas are starts with equal sign. Next one. The data in formula can consist of any of the following. Values, cell addresses, functions, operator, parenthesis. Inside the one values, second one cell address up to 5. Okay. String and numeric value. Inside the value, what is string? String is set of character. See, hello is set of characters. Another string is everyone. Next, to create a formula, first you have to use the is equal to sign, then click on the D2 cell, hello string. To concatenate, I am using the ampersand sign, then after that the everyone, both the string will coming together. Next one, numeric value means numbers is equal to any number you can give. So formula consists of values. Second one, cell addresses. This one is the B3 cell. This cell address is B3. This is the name box. We will see the cell address in name box. B3. See the name box here. Next one, functions. Again, start with is equal to. First, I will try sum, open bracket. This is built-in function. After that, any number you give, but every number should separated by comma. Close the bracket, press enter. See the formula. Fourth one, operators. You can use any operator, plus, minus, into, division, greater than, lesser than. 62 divided by 2, press the enter, 31. Next one, parenthesis. I will show how to use the average function using the parenthesis. Means our formula consists of value, cell address, function, operator, parenthesis. First is equal to average, open bracket, any number you can give, but separated by comma, press the enter. Thus a formula in MS Excel is sequence of values, cell addresses, functions and operators in a cell that produces a new value. What is cell and range of references? A reference identifies cells or a range of cells in a worksheet and tells Excel where to look for the values or data we want to use in formula. First one, See the example here. 10 to 10. 10 colon 10 means is equal to. Cell reference means identifying range of cells. More than one cells. This one is the C4. C4 cell is equal to C4. This is the range. Next one. EE means full column you have to select. EE. Next one, all cell in row 2 through E. 2 to E. Next, all cell in columns A through D. AD, all columns, first row, all columns, A to D columns. Next one, the range of cells in row 4 and column B through H. Row, same row, different columns, B to H. Next one, E1 to E15 means same column, row different. 1 to 15 you have to select. 1 to 15 row you have to select. Next one, B10, D20, different row, different columns. B10 to D20, like this you have to select. This is the range references, means identify the range of cells. How to identify range of cells in formula? Next one is formulas. To enter a formula, select a cell and enter the formula in the cell or in the formula bar. I will show this with example. It's in your textbook. First you have to enter the values. It contains 4 steps. Click on cell, type equal sign, continue typing formula and press enter or press equal right sign. Total. Click on the cell E2 is equal to sign, second step. Then click the cell address B2, 62 in B2 cell. Next one C2, 87, 91 is in D2 cell. Then press the enter, otherwise press right sign near the formula bar. Next one is pointing. An easier method of adding a cell references to formula is to click on the cell instead of typing the cell address. Just click on the cell and take the cell address. This method is called pointing. Click on the cell and take the cell address. Thank you.